My name is Jeetanji, coming to you from Los Angeles, California. And now we've got our real estate buzz with Mia McLeod.
This real estate buzz segment is brought to you by McLeod & Associates, a full-service real estate and mortgage firm. It's not about the number of homes we sell. It's about the difference we make in people's lives.
Our resident real estate expert, Mia McLeod, kamusta?
Mabuti naman. Thanks for having me and magandang hapon sa mga viewers natin.
Ang galing-galing magtagalog nito. O sige, pag-usapan na natin. Ano ba ang pagkakaiba ng pre-qualification versus pre-approval pagdating sa pagbili ng bahay?
That's a great question, kapatid. Now, a lot of people think if they get a pre-qualification that really is a true assessment of how much they can buy a home or borrow, yes. But a pre-qual really is like a snapshot. And it's more like an estimate. Sometimes you don't even have to submit your financial documentation for it, which is why we don't do pre-qualifications at our office. We do pre-approvals. A pre-approval is when you submit your financial documentation, it gets reviewed, the numbers get reviewed, credit gets pulled, and it's a true accurate depiction of how much you could get qualified for.
Okay, so what do you need to get pre-approved? That's what we want to know.
Not as much as many people think, just a few documents, a loan application, which your loan officer can provide, the borrower authorization form, which also the loan officer can provide, your two most recent pay stubs, last 2 years W-2s, last 2 years tax returns, two most recent bank statements, and a 401k statement if applicable. If you get that and you hand it over to your loan officer, they should be able to pre-approve you.
Okay, and how long does it take usually to pre-approve?
Once you submit a complete file like that, our office in particular can get it done within 24 to 48 hours.
Wow, that's impressive.
Yes.
That's short, huh?
Yes, and at that point we can assess what loan programs you can take advantage of, how much loan you could get approved for, and what your monthly estimated payments will look like.
Okay, so what is lender credit? Can you explain that?
Yes, and a lot of families don't know that this is a viable option out there. In 2010, when the mortgage industry changed and we all had to get licensed as loan professionals, the banks also changed this particular situation where they now give closing cost credit to the borrower. So, for example, we had a buyer that took out an FHA loan, bought $430,000, and all they had to do is come up with the down payment. They got $11,000 in closing cost credit.
Wow, yeah, so that's a lot of money.
A lot, imagine. So whenever you buy, of course, there's down payment and there's closing cost, but in this particular case, all they had to do is come up with the down payment portion.
Okay, great. Okay, let's talk about the common things called out in an appraisal.
Oh my goodness, yes. And these are things, and I do a lot of workshops in front of realtors and to the community at large, and this is something that can easily be avoided, so I always like to highlight that. Mm-hmm. Smoke detectors, number one. When an appraiser goes out to your property to estimate the value of that, they're gonna look that and review and make sure that there's smoke detectors. So they want that in each room, kitchen, hallway, living room, all of that. Next thing is the carbon monoxide detector. Mm-hmm. They want, if it's two stories, they want one for each level. And a properly strapped water heater. So simple items, but I tell you, sometimes people are missing them, and what it does, it causes the appraiser to have to go back out a second time.
Which costs money again.
Which costs more money for the borrower or the buyer, and it could delay your closing like 3 to 5 days, because we have to set up a whole new appointment with them to come back out again.
Right, so the best thing to do is make sure you have all of those.
All of these, yeah,
right.
Simple. I mean, you could get all of these from Lowe's and Home Depot. So when you know,
but it's the fact that you have to do it before the appraiser
comes out. Absolutely correct.
Right. Yes. Okay. Well, we want to celebrate our kababayans.
Yes.
We have success stories to share with all of you from McLeod & Associates.
Yes, the Itzan family and Guevara family. We want to congratulate them on their new home purchase.
Look at that! Yay! Look at the Itzan family with the two children. Now they'll have a home where they can run around in.
Yes.
Amazing. And of course, to the Guevara family.
Yes. Oh my goodness! Congratulations to them as well. They are first-time home buyers, so it's been a true honor to be a part of the process with them.
Congratulations to the families, and of course, thank you so much to McLeod and Associates for making their dreams come true, diba? And we want to share with all our kababayans that McLeod and Associates has free consultation for buying, selling, and mortgage reviews. You can also get a free online home evaluation. Just make sure to go to the website, www.mcleodsmarthomeprice.com.
And as you know, G, referrals are always welcome. And like you mentioned, we do free buyer and seller consults. They take about 45 minutes to an hour, but this is where we sit down at the office, go over your goals, what the process looks like, what market trends look like, and come up with a good game plan for you to purchase or to sell.
All right. Thank you so much, Mia, for being here and sharing all your knowledge with our kababayans.
Always a treat. Thanks, kapatid.
All right. Maraming salamat at maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Remember, go to McLeod and Associates. They can help make your dreams come true. All right, ako po si G. Tonji, nagpapaalam mula sa Los Angeles, California. Bye!